Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. Welcome to the Keep Productive YouTube channel if you're brand new, and if you're a regular, welcome back. So today's video, what we're going to be doing is taking a look at Setapp. For those who don't know, Setapp is an application that it's basically the Netflix for Mac apps. You've got hundreds of Mac apps available in one suite at a set monthly rate. Now, I'm very honored that the team at Setapp has sponsored Keep Productive YouTube channel for like a week. And also they've gone really over above and beyond and sponsored the podcast for an entire series. So series two of the Tools They Use podcast, if you haven't checked it out yet, is now a Setapp sponsored thing. So it's amazing to have their support. And I'm already a user and a big fan of their stuff. So it's great to have that. So guys, what I want to do today is sort of overview how you can get to use Setapp, giving you a few thoughts on the pricing and overviewing the resource. Now, a little bit of an introduction to Setapp. The resource is designed to help you find tons of Mac apps, but just for like one fee per month. The big problem with applications is if we get, like, for example, the Mac App Store open, you obviously go to the, when you've got a Mac and you're like starting out, you have to go to the Mac App Store and you're paying all of these either one-off fees for applications and you're like, oh man, I'm paying so much. Or once you download the application, you're paying for these recurring fees and you're like, man, these are totaling up to be big bills. The idea behind Setapp is to essentially refine that by giving you a ton of applications. And if you just go to all apps, you can see this at a glance. You've got hundreds here that are so useful, and ones that are very popular as well, but just for a monthly rate. So you can either download them or not. So for example, these won't come pre-installed on your device. So for example, okay, I get my Setapp subscription. I'm like, okay, day one, they won't all be installed. You can download them when and where you need them, which is great. So for example, let's say I'm like, okay, to do, which you guys all know. Okay, I'm gonna install it and have it available on my Setapp. And this will be a nice version of to do as well. One that has the majority of the functionality. So as you can imagine, it's pretty awesome in terms of being able to have to install stuff. But let me explain a few of the benefits of this. Of course, let's say like, okay, oh man, I need to get a GIF creator. So all you have to do is type in an item, and what it can do is it will search the resources to find you the best application that would sort it out. And of course, I can use that one to record and share GIFs. So it's very helpful in terms of being able to find stuff. So if you're a startup business and you're like, you know, I don't have a hideous amount of money to buy a new application every time, but I need access to a ton of them, then this can be great for you. Now, the application is accessible on the top bar as well, so you can pop there and search for an app. So for example, I'm like, okay, I'm gonna search Ulysses. You can click into it and see everything there. Or you can open your Setapp folder, which can be found here. Or if you're finding yourself really awesome, you can find all of your Setapp apps available in your favorites inside of the Finder. So it's pretty easily accessible. Now, they've got a really nice dashboard here, so you can see some of the things they've recently added. So they've added BusyCam recently. You can install it and get access to it instead of paying a high fee inside. But it's just really, really helpful in terms of being able to have, and they're adding new applications all the time. So you can see on this left-hand panel, they've categorized the items into different lifestyle ones. So these are just for everyday usage to some extent. They've got tons of popular applications and everything from email to note takers to news explorers to journal apps to IM apps. Creating applications, so this might be for the designer that's looking for something to use to get something done. Developer tools, so again, something that really surpasses my area of interest. Productivity, and you can find all of the great productivity applications, some really popular names. Pajico I saw in there, Unibox, and also BeFocus. There's many ones there. Mac hacks, so these are ones for your internal system to improve. You got writing and blogging, so that was probably Ulysses will be there. Yep, a very popular one. Education and research, as you can see here, a nice overview of some of these ones. Maintenance and all of these great maintenance applications. Task management, so it goes into specific items as well, and personal finance as well. So you can see as well what ones you've got installed. So I've got about 7 installed. But if I wanted to at any given time, like, okay, I need storage or need space, I could uninstall one, which is pretty easy to do. But all of these applications are really accessible, so it makes it a lot easier. So in terms of accessing this one, you need a subscription. The subscription is really reasonable. So in terms of the fees, you have obviously a set amount each month that you pay. So for example, monthly, it would be just billed monthly $9.99, which I think is really reasonable for access to 100 applications plus. You've also got an annual rate. So if you pay annually, and that's billed annually, it's $8.99. So you'd be saving $1 a month. And if you're an educational institution, then you can pay $5 per month, and that's billed annually. And of course, below they have an outline of all of the pricing per country as well, including VAT. So guys, hopefully that was a nice overview for you. Let me know in the comments what you think of Setapp. Let me know if you have any questions. More than happy to answer them. But a huge thank you to Setapp for sponsoring the week on Keep Productive, as well as sponsoring the full Tools They Use podcast. Anyway, guys, thanks so much for stopping by. Make sure to check out all the good stuff in the link below. There'll be a link to Setapp as well as some more information there. But guys, thanks so much for stopping by. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.